who's hanging from your back.
I'd like you to meet Terrapin carolina. That's the scientific name for the eastern box turtle. Turtles are not only slow-moving, everybody knows that, but eastern box turtles are also slow-living. That means they reach maturity late, they have few offspring, and they live a long life.
And then you let people know that these are an animal that's of concern to us in North Carolina. So we've box turtles have been around a long time. So what's their status now? Do we have box turtles? How many do we have? What should we do? What can we do to maintain this population?
Turtles have survived because they are amazingly adaptable. Almost any habitat can be called home, from forest to grassland. Turtles will also eat almost anything, insects, fruit, even dead animals. And turtles can also escape predators pretty easily. That shell comes in handy. That's why eastern box turtles are found along most of the East Coast and into the Midwest and the Southeast. The eastern box turtle is also found in every county in North Carolina. That's part of the reason it's the state reptile.
We don't know how they're doing right now. And they're a generalist species, so they can live in lots of different kinds of habitats. Where are they most abundant? Why are they most abundant there? And what are the problems that they're facing?
But in a fast-paced world, the slow living that has helped the turtle survive through the ages also puts the turtle at risk from human activity. Roads and development can fragment a turtle's habitat.
So zone 17 for UTMs.
That's why these high school students from around the state are joining researchers in this forest in Orange County.
You're going to measure from the hinge to the anterior portion of the plastron.
This field research is part of the Box Turtle Cooperative, a statewide effort involving four universities and five state agencies to learn the status of the eastern box turtle, identify threats to its survival, and develop a long-term conservation strategy. Biologists at UNC Greensboro are heading the project.
Okay, so what'd you get?
What makes us concerned about how well they're doing is the fact that they need to live a long time in order to reproduce themselves. So a turtle might have to be a half a century old or more before it replaces itself in the population, has offspring. It may be older than that. We don't know. They're slow. They are vulnerable to decline because of the fast-paced world that we live in and the rate of development.
However, turtles don't like to be found. That's why they are so beautifully camouflaged. So, for this research trip, scientists brought in specially trained turtle tracking dogs. The dogs are trained to find and very gently pick up the turtles.
So these dogs immediately pick up any and all turtles and bring them to me. And the way they find these turtles is not visually, but using scent trails. Turtles, when they travel, they apparently leave a very faint scent trail so that male and female turtles can find each other.
Turtle IDs.
Once the turtles are found, the location is documented. The turtle is also measured and weighed. The sex is determined. Red eyes and a concave plastron, that's the bottom of the shell, are the typical signs for a male. The turtle's age is also estimated by counting the rings on the scutes, or the scales of the shell. It's kind of like counting the rings of a tree.
Take any scoot. You can count this one, this one, this.
This turtle is a male, about 15 years old.
Just looking at them and marking them and studying animals is my favorite part.
Students, with guidance from teachers and researchers, do all the work.
For example, the parts of the turtle shell, I had no idea what they were called. Like, the top is the carapace, the bottom is the plastron.
And the next one, so you close it up, zero it again.
This is a great opportunity for me to get out in the field and have some fun and learn some new techniques that I don't know about.
Lastly, the turtle is identified and labeled before being released.
If you go around the lateral edge of the turtle, they have individual scales. So we assign a letter to each one of these scales.
That unique marking process created the name AMV for this turtle. That's important because if turtle AMV is captured again, researchers can compare the data to see how the turtle has grown and whether its habitat has changed. The turtle is then released exactly where it was found.
If you're actually immersed in nature, it gives you a different appreciation. So rather than sitting in four walls, you know, you get out, you can smell the air and see the leaves and the plants and the animals. And
turtles are homebodies, not just because they live in a shell, but they'll spend their entire life in a range of only a few acres. So it's important, if you find a turtle, to put it back exactly where you found it. Unless, of course, it's crossing a road or by the side of the road. In that case, you want to put it in a safe place in the direction it was heading. How's that? The Box Turtle Project started in 2007. It's designed to last 100 years. There are 30 locations around the state where data is routinely collected, including state parks and large privately held tracts of land, like this forest. All the data is entered into a database managed by the Wildlife Resources Commission. Scientists are already analyzing the information that's been collected to see what can be learned about the health of the turtle population.
What makes them wonderful advocates for the natural world is that you can pick them up, you can hold them and learn from them, and they don't harm you. They are our North Carolina state reptile, and they are familiar to a lot of people across the state. So they're good ambassadors for the natural world. They are good indicators of habitat.